Don't know what to believe about COVID-19? Let's bust the top coronavirus myths with me right now. What's up? Dulcie Marcel Vicente here, providing you Med Remedy. This is episode 1 of the 4-part series CoronaV, Upclose, and Evidence Base. As COVID-19 infects millions each day, so does millions get misinformed about it. A lot of misconceptions and conspiracy theories have emerged, but we're here to clear and clarify the top 7 coronavirus misconceptions. Starting with number 1. Antibiotics can prevent COVID-19. Antibiotics works against bacteria, and coronavirus is a virus that belongs to the family Coronaviridae. But why does healthcare professionals prescribe antibiotics? This is because the immune system can go down during the course of COVID-19 infection, making the patient vulnerable to bacterial infections as a complication. Hence, antibiotics are prescribed. So, if you're using antibiotics, it should be under the direct supervision of a physician and should never be used as part of self-medication. Number 2. As long as it's sunny outside, I'm protected against COVID-19. Although sunlight was found to inactivate SARS-CoV-2, which is the causative agent of coronavirus disease, in a study conducted by Michael Schrich of the National Biodefense Analysis and Countermeasure Center using simulated sunlight, their research measured the decay rate of a saliva containing SARS-CoV-2, the causative agent of COVID-19, and exposed it to simulated sunlight representative of late winter and summer season. The saliva exposed to the late winter simulated sunlight showed a 90% decay rate of 19 minutes, while the summer sunlight has a 90% decay rate of 6 minutes. If the saliva is not exposed to any sunlight at all, the 90% decay rate is achieved at 125 minutes. But even if sunlight can deactivate the virus, it would take some time to do so. Plus, we have to consider the different levels of sunlight present in a particular place. So the best protection we have is to stay at home, wash your hands, maintain social distancing, and when going out, wear our mask. Number 3. Gurgling diluted bleach can protect me from COVID-19. Bleach is a disinfectant. And a disinfectant means that it should be used outside of the body, never inside. Plus, diluted bleach, whatever form it may be, is an irritant. And in certain concentrations, it can irritate the inner linings and can corrode any part of your body. So should you gargle bleach? Never. Don't do it. It's hazardous, it's poisonous, it's toxic. What should you do? You wash your hands with soap and water, use alcohol, stay at home, and wear your mask. Number 4. 5G, according to the conspiracy theorists, helps spread coronavirus disease. Some people claim that 5G helps viruses communicate, often citing a paper from 2011. In this study, the authors conclude that bacteria can communicate via electromagnetic signals. According to them, the electromagnetic signals between different bacteria within a community is a wireless version of intercellular communication found in bacterial communities connected by nanowires. The wireless broadcast can, in principle, be of both the AM and FM variety. However, experts dispute this theory, and SARS-CoV is a virus, not a bacteria. Also, if 5G helps spread the virus, why is COVID-19 present in countries without 5G? For example, Sweden. Sweden has 74,000 confirmed cases and 5,526 deaths, and that country has no 5G. Why is COVID-19 present there? It just goes to show that it's not 5G who helps spread the virus. It's the droplets from infectious and asymptomatic carriers who doesn't wear their masks, who doesn't stay at home, and does not maintain social distancing. 5. Everyone with COVID-19 dies! This statement is untrue, as COVID-19 is only fatal for a small percentage of people. According to the Chinese Center for Disease Control and Prevention, 80.9% of COVID-19 cases were mild and will recover without needing special treatment or without going to the hospital. But when does COVID-19 become fatal? Roughly 1 in 5 people with COVID-19 will experience serious illness, and this is because they got underlying health conditions known as comorbid conditions. What are those comorbid conditions? Hypertension, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, cancer, and chronic respiratory disease. So how can we protect ourselves? Stay at home, wear your mask, maintain social distancing, and wash your hands. Number 6. Cats and dogs can transmit COVID-19. Several reports showed cats and dogs get sick with COVID-19. However, we have to know that these cats and dogs became sick after being in contact with patients who has coronavirus disease. In experimental conditions, both cats and ferrets were able to transmit infection to other animals of the same species. However, up until this time, there's still no evidence that these animals can transmit the disease to humans and spread COVID-19. COVID-19 is mainly spread through droplets produced when an infected person coughs, sneezes, or speaks. So wear your mask, do social distancing, wash your hands. All those cats and dogs reported to have COVID-19 have recovered 100%. Number 7. COVID-19 is a man-made bioweapon. I know you find it puzzling for a virus to take over the whole world in such a short span of time, infecting millions and killing thousands. But let's get to the point. To genetically engineer a new virus, scientists can combine pieces of viruses they've seen before. In case of a genetically engineered coronavirus that was designed to infect humans, the bulk of its genetic material, its backbone, would come from SARS or a close relative we've seen before. But the backbone of COVID-19 doesn't look like any disease-causing virus, and other key parts of the virus are new and distinct. Researchers led by Shan Lu Liu at the Ohio State University say there is no credible evidence of genetic engineering. The virus genome has been sequenced, and if it had been altered, we would expect to see signs of inserted gene sequences. But we know now that the points that differ from bad viruses are scattered in a fairly random way, just as they would be if the new virus had evolved naturally. It is more likely that SARS-CoV-2 is a recombinant coronavirus created in nature between a bad coronavirus and another coronavirus in an intermediate animal host. And there you have it, the 7 misconceptions cleared and clarified. If you have questions for specific segments, don't be shy and comment it down below. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe, click like, and share with someone who needs to know about it. I'll see you next week on another video about CoronaV up close and evidence-based.